So glad you tuned in to WLJC tonight. It's such a blessing this station is, and we're thankful for WLJC, but most of all tonight, we're thankful for our wonderful Lord Jesus Christ.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to another night of our spring telethon. We know that most people have been out today and enjoyed some beautiful weather, and we hope that you brought all that sunshine and happiness back in your house, and you're in a good mood, and you're going to be calling us tonight and letting us hear from you and help us with this project that we are in. And we are blessed tonight to have a lot of good phone operators. We have Carolyn Davis from the Brutus Baptist Church. We have Ruby Sizemore from the Size Rock Baptist Church, and Elizabeth Couch from the Oneida Community Church. We have a phone operator from the Body of Christ Church at Irvin, and some from the Tar Ridge Union Church. Now, see, if all of these could work together, I want you to look. That is going to be wonderful. But you know, it shows one thing. Everybody loves the Lord, and they realize what this is about. It's not about building somebody up or anything like that. We are all here to try to keep the gospel going out to those that need it. And so, you know, if you have a burden for souls and want to help, well, then we welcome you to come aboard. Mm-hmm. But, you know, on the other hand, if you don't really care about what we're doing or don't have a vision for winning souls, then, you know, you'd only be in our way. Mm-hmm. And so we say that firmly because, you know, we want people that love the Lord. This place has gone through too much blood, sweat, and tears for people to just come and exhibit their talent.
Amen.
And if you do that, I mean, when you want to do that, there's a place like Nashville and New York and California. You go there. But, you know, we're here for a reason.
That's right.
And
that's
we right. have to keep sharing that. The Lord knows what it's all about. And, you know, I got a letter today that just really, really touched me. But we'll, I might as well read it now since I mentioned it. And I won't give her name, but it's talking about the ministry here. And it says, enjoying the program so much. I am a pastor's wife, and even though the ministers love what they do, people don't really understand what ministers go through. If each church member would give a small gift in honor of their pastor, this would help WLJC and bring honor to their pastor, and while helping get souls saved and Christians lifted up. Sometimes just a simple thank you means so much, and we can sure say amen to that. And so said, I challenge the church congregation to give a small gift to WLJC in honor of their pastor, and me and my husband. We have been Christians for almost 37 years. And as we near our new home, we say we don't regret a mile. We sing in the church a lot, and I have learned so many good songs from WLJC. That's something else to think about. Just the little things mean so much. God has been so good to me, my husband, and children and grandchildren. Just one of God's servants. And so I thought that was good coming from a pastor's wife about just, you know, people have just seems to have forgotten nice little thank yous and just a courtesy,
yes.
You know, just being courteous to somebody.
Yes.
And it's just this gimme spirit and just, you know, Well, anyway, you heard what she said here. So if you'd like to call in honor of your pastor and tell where the church is located, I'll tell them up there on the phones to take down where they say your church is, and we will give recognition to it. And also, I think it would be a good way to do this. Mm-hmm. And so, Robin, what did you think about being a pastor's wife?
Well, it's a job I never really wanted. It's a lot of responsibility. It's a lot. I stand behind Alan 100%. You know, I don't want to ever try to tell him something that God ain't telling him. You know, I respect him to hear from God, and I think that's a lot of it. Just having enough respect to know that God's speaking. You know, to. But he's the same way with me. If he feels like the Lord's speaking to me to do something, he's behind me 100%. It's it's the same either way. But I'm just so thankful to be here tonight. Thankful to such a privilege to be associated with this ministry. So such a privilege to be here on this hill. I've been here many times. I've never come in this place. Never fail to feel the Lord's presence when I come in. And I just think it's a blessing. And I don't understand why churches don't want to support this place. The souls that are won through here have to go somewhere to church. Mm-hmm. You know, we need this place. And I thank God for it every day. And we need to get behind Sister Margaret and the team here at WLJC and try to stand behind them in prayer. And in our offerings, and just lift them up before the Lord, and bind every demon in hell from their backs in the name of Jesus. Amen. And we need to stand up and be warriors for God instead of just sitting back and letting Satan take over. Amen. And we just need to lift His name. We're here to lift His name up tonight, and I'm thankful to that.
Yes. All right, Alan.
I'm just glad you said something nice, honey. No.
He was
I was just real nervous there, Edith. No, I'm just kidding about that. I have three jobs, and Sister Margaret, I have, I'm not good at all at getting out and visiting people like I should. But this station goes in and visits them every night.
That's right.
And, I just hear from hundreds of people that tell me all the time what a blessing this station is.
Yes.
And it's just over and over and over. Now, occasionally you'll run into someone that fights against this station, mm-hmm. you know, when they really give it down the road. Mm-hmm. But for every one of those that I run into 100 or more that just says what a blessing it is, mm-hmm. you know. And I think if you put your money here, just ask the Lord, and He'll let you know how much to give, and put your money into this. I think when we get up there and we see the souls that this station has won, I think we'll be amazed, you know.
Yes.
There's a little statistics that I heard a few months ago, and two different census reports, they both say about the same thing. 148,000 people die each day. You know, and that's how many is stepping into eternity. Mm-hmm. 148. Now that varies every day. You know, it's not the same every day, but that's a staggering amount of people.
Yes, it is.
But when you hear of how many people that this station has the potential to reach each day,
amen.
You know, going around the world and in other countries, and just in this state alone, how many counties. It's amazing what God has done here.
Amen.
And if you want a place to support that is winning souls, you know, I believe everyone should support their home church.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
And most of the people that go to church with us, they do support this station.
Yes.
And but you know, just pray and ask God. Say, God, what can I do? How much should I give? And just be led by the Lord, because I know He can let you know. He can speak directly to your heart tonight.
Amen.
If you'll just
right.
ask Him.
Yeah. Amen.
All right, thank you. And we have Edith. What's on your mind?
Not much, Margaret. I don't have much to say tonight. What about that?
Well,
You've been to the doctor today. She tried to burst up a bunch of that ice back in the winter storm and had kind of messed up her knees. So she's been crippling around here today.
Yeah, a little bit. So about 4 or 5 weeks ago I did that. But thank God that it's not bad enough they're going to have to do surgery. So, but they do have me in a brace and everything on my knees. So, but I'm just thankful to be here, Margaret, and thankful to be a part of WLJC. And I was just thinking as Robin was talking, you know, sometimes we're not bold enough as Christians to do what we need to do. And, you know, I heard a song that Dan hadn't heard in a long time. It says, I went to the enemy's camp and took back what they stole from me. Mm-hmm. And I was almost shouting going down the road driving my car. I thought, whoa, I hadn't heard that in a long time. But it made me think we need to do that quite often. Go back and say, I've come to take what you've stolen from me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And if you're fighting something tonight, you know, God's in control of all things, but let's don't forget them. We need your money, and we only come to you 2 times a year to ask for your pledges and donations, and what you can give will be used for uplifting of God's name. It's not just thrown out there to just do frivolous things with. It's used for God's kingdom,
Amen.
And that's the reason I believe in it. I'm a firm believer in it. I back it, and everybody I talk to, I try to encourage him. And I was just talking to a guy. He messaged me today and said, I wanted you to know I gave... donated to WLJC, first time ever. And I thought, well, that's wonderful, you know. He'd been watching, first time he'd watched, I think. I mean, he'd watched, but not really watched, you know what I'm saying? And so I thank God for that we're being a witness to people, and that's what we need to do, because Margaret, time's running out.
Yes.
Yeah, we need to get people saved, and that's our sole purpose. After we're saved is to get other people saved. I believe that from bottom of my heart. So.
Yes.
Okay, we have,
Brother
Bill.
Bill. I've called him Bill, Bob, two or three names already tonight. So whoever you are, just go ahead and talk about telephone.
Amen. Well, it's a privilege to be here, Sister Margaret, and just another time with you guys. And, man, that just fired me up by Sister Ratliff's testimony. You know, Jesus always makes us the aggressor. In his word, how he says, to give, it'll be given unto you. Mm-hmm. Seek, and you shall find.
Yes.
And so he always puts that into our court first.
Right.
And so as he says, to give, it shall be given unto you. And I just love to see people give. And I was amazed of the souls so far that's been saved upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
People are praying for them. Because as they were talking about the honoring the pastors last week, Sister Ruby Treadway, she's 84 years old, a lover. She's one of my babies in the church, but she hasn't been able to come to church much. And she called in last week and in honor of me as her pastor, and I just appreciate that. And so tonight what we done, I had Sister Lynn write out a check to WLJC in honor of some of the shut-ins that... It's not that there's something wrong. They just can't get out as much as they used to.
Right.
And so we just want to bless her and just Mary and Hardy. And, you know, there's just different ones that their church now is WLJC. So we're just privileged and honored to be here and just to be part of this wonderful ministry that's reaching out to the lost.
Amen.
And we've dealt with a lot of people on the phones that calls in with just every kind of problem.
Yeah,
I mean, there's a lot of hurting people out there.
Sure.
And if I can, just real brief, years ago before I got saved, that's back in the day when we had the rabbit ears on our TV.
Yeah.
I had 3 channels, and I turned in and tuned in, and I don't even remember who the preacher was, but it was just like God was talking to me through the TV.
Mm-hmm.
And I went in there and I poured out all my beer, and I just began to weep on my couch, and it was just the power how the Lord was using the TV ministry,
mm-hmm.
reaching into
yes.
people's homes.
Yes.
And so I just trust God that there's going to be souls saved tonight.
Yes, mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
God is going to bless, as he said in Haggai 2:8, the silver and gold is his, saith the Lord.
Yes.
And so he just makes us stewards over his finances,
exactly.
allows us to have some of that.
That's right.
And so we're just glad to be here and just part of what God's going to do tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, thank you very much. And so you'll be hearing them read a lot of your calls that came in. And right quick, Robin, you've already gotten one.
I do. I have about a half page here.
Okay.
Elry from Hyden pledges $10. Battle Scar Soldiers from Garrett pledges $100 for the Jail and Prison Ministries call-in. Virgil Lunsford from Lawrenceburg pledges $100, married for 74 years. Wilburn Godfrey from Wayne pledges $50 in honor of David Wendell. Lisa Ridner from Pulaski pledges $25 in honor of Jesus. Anthony and Brenda pledges $20. Name withheld from Nancy pledges $100. Lisa pledges $5. Brenda Jenkins from Wayne pledges $50. Robert Helton from Wellington pledges $10. Elizabeth Couch pledges $100 in memory of Troy Couch.
All right, thank you. And you know, in the mail, we just get such good letters. I got a 4 or 5 page letter today from a 91-year-old retired minister, and he's talking about how much good he gets from watching WLJC since he no longer drives and cannot go to church very often. Mm-hmm. But he's being fed spiritually, and it was so good that he was just thanking the Lord for Christian TV.
Yes.
And then also there was another letter that came in from a man that was in prison, and he wanted prayer for himself, and he said drugs put him there, and he had one another man there that he wanted prayer for. But see, we're going into the jails, and we're going into these homes that they can't get up, they can't go like they would like to. So it, see, this gives us an opportunity to be worth something, do something
exactly.
that will amount to something, and that is provide good gospel programming for them so they can be fed spiritually.
Yes.
All right.
That's good.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. And so that brings our total up to, what is it,
Edith? 107.
No, it's good. Went to just 108.
Okay.
108.05.
All right, that's good. And so we're going to pray as our first group comes up to sing. And we have two good groups now.
Yeah,
and
is.
So you will have plenty of time to go.
Right.
And so sometimes we put things off, and the enemy will sure give you things to to distract you from going to the phone and doing what you need to. We need to be praying tonight for Sister Pat Crider and her husband Bill. He had surgery on his brain yesterday, and he's in ICU, of course, in the hospital. And she said to please ask everybody to pray.
Yes.
So right now, let's pray. Robin, lead us in prayer for the service and for everybody that will be involved, either through the airwaves or the ones that are here.
Okay. Father God, we come to you tonight on behalf of the station. Ask you, Lord Jesus, just to send your word out over these airways tonight, and let the power of God, the anointing of the Holy Ghost, just go forward and touch people's hearts tonight. Lord, let the spirit of giving just enter every airway tonight in Jesus' name, and bring in the finances that this station desperately needs for the next till the next telethon. Father God, I bind every spirit of the enemy that would hinder in any way tonight. I rebuke it. Every assignment the enemy has sent against this station, I rebuke it right now over these airways in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the blood is applied, and it's no spirit of the enemy, no assignment of the enemy can cause any harm in Jesus' name. And Lord, we just thank you for doing the work tonight. We praise you for it.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
All right. Thank you so much. All right. For our first group, we have Heaven's Jubilee from East Bernstadt. And if you want to call them, it's 423-9112-3552 and talk to Tammy. All right. I believe they're all ready to go over there. So let's welcome Heaven's Jubilee.
Long road I carried a heavy, heavy load, don't you see? One day the Lord looked in my heart and he said to me, why don't you roll it labored through the great, great trial. I struggled so many, many miles, don't you see? By faith, I met the Lord and I heard Him say to me, why don't you roll that burden on me? Why don't you roll that burden on me? Oh, you may stumble on your way. Oh, tell breaking down from worry day by day. Why don't you roll that burden on me? Well, now I'm running down this long, long road. Well, I'm as happy as I can be. Thank God He's spoken to my heart and He said to me, why don't you roll that burden on me? Why don't you roll that burden on me? Though you may stumble on your way. Don't stop breaking down from worry day by day. Why don't you roll that burden on me? Roll that burden over on me. Roll that burden over on me. Roll that heavy burden on me.
I want to say I thank the Lord tonight for being here, being a part of this, and you know, everybody that's watching, our friends and family and stuff. I'd hope that you're going to call in and donate. The number's on the screen there, and if you don't, I may find out about it. If you don't, I may just find out about it. But no, y'all be sure call and donate, because I tell you, when I'm out in public and stuff, and I run into so many people that watches this program. A lot of them's not even saved. They don't go to church, but they do watch this faithfully. A lot of sinner people watches this more faithfully than what a lot of Christian people do. Than a lot of Christian people, it's bedfast and stuff. They can't get out to church. This is the only church that they've gotten. And, you know, I know I've said it before, but, you know, it is the truth. This is the only church that most people will ever, you know, be able to watch. This is the most church that most sinner people's ever going to watch, too. So, meanwhile, y'all call in. Call that number on the screen there and donate. Let's see. Got it working on the building. Yours is a preacher. Mine's a gambler and a sinner, I think.
I'm a working on a building. I'm working on a building. I'm a working on a building for my Lord, for my Lord. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building for my Lord, for my Lord. If I was a preacher, I'd tell you what I'd do. I'd keep praying on a preacher, I'd work on the building too. I'm working on the building. I'm working on the building. I'm working on the building for my Lord, for my Lord. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building. If I was a singer, I'd tell you what I'd do. I'd keep right on singing, and I'd work on the building too. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building for my Lord. for my Lord. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building. It's a Holy Ghost building for my Lord, for my
We all need to pitch in and work on the building for the Lord. And, you know, that's the only thing that I'm doing this for, because it sure ain't for entertainment. I always say I ain't got the patience and time or money for entertainment. I believe if we done it for entertainment, we'd probably go broke anyway. But, you know, I thank God he's made this opportunity for us to be over here tonight, and appreciate Sister Margaret and them having us over here. And
oh, yes.
Just, you know, being able to be a part of something that I know that the Lord has put together.
That's right.
And, you know, and he surely has, and I know he keeps on blessing this station. And a lot of people, I wish they could come over here and actually see what does go on in the back that nobody sees. And, you know, I could tell people when I run into them, they start talking about the station, asking about it and stuff. I said, you know, I said, everybody over there, they really are what they say that they are. You know, and they love the Lord. And I know that everybody here loves the Lord. And they all pray and stuff. I mean, they really seek the Lord. They're sure not doing this just because they ain't got nothing else to do, because there's a lot. And I couldn't even imagine. There's a lot to run in this station. And but sure think Sister Margaret does a good job.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to try this. So sweet at the feet of Jesus. I want to send, first of all, I want to send this out to my Tommy's kids, Amber and Keisha and Bud and Johnny and LaReagan and Cheyenne and my sister Helen. Thank her for babysitting. Bless her heart. Helen Curry, I love you.
We love you, Helen.
And Pujo Couch, he's watching. I think he likes this song here.
Shirley Dixon.
Yeah, Shirley Dixon. Jesus sat at me. She brought before him an alabaster box. She began to weep with tears that fell from broken heart. She began to wash his feet. She dried them with her very hair and kissed him tenderly. Oh, it's so
amen. I believe that song too.
Amen.
Yeah. I really do. Wilma Ratliff from Wellington pledges 200 in memory of a husband and two sons in honor of Tarr Ridge Church and Pastor Alan Ratliff. Tarr Ridge Union Church from Frenchburg pledges 300. Matt and Jill Wilwine from Madison pledges $10 for Grandma Ina. Julia Stone from Menifee pledges $20 in honor of Jubilee Singers. Earl Spacey from Morgan pledges 200. A name withheld from Fayette pledges 100 in honor of WLJC.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Goldie and Earl Berger from Montgomery pledges $20 in honor of Earl and Earl and Goldie, I guess. Peggy Smith from Laurel pledges $100 in honor of Pastor Bobby Hilton. Betty Banks from Clark pledges $100 in honor of Margaret and all the workers. Larry and Garietta Vanderpool from Menifee pledges $50 in honor of Pastor Gary Mayab. Carol from Wolf pledges $10. Name Withheld from Bath pledges $25 in honor of Jesus and Lost Family. Name Withheld from Clay pledges $100. Wanda Maynard from Russell pledges $25 in memory of Virgil Luttrell. Glenna Emerson from Casey pledges $25 in honor of Pastor Gary Allen. Ruth Easterling from Morgan pledges $50 in memory of Stanley Easterling. Phyllis and Bill Brogan from Morgan pledges $50. Name Withheld pledges $20 in honor of Pastor Gary LaRoot. Rosetta Brancom from Wayne pledges $100 in honor of Pastor Jackson Burton. Barbara Harrison from Powell pledges $50 in honor of Pastor. Jeff and Sandy Phillips from Lee pledges $25 in honor of Pastor Alma Ray Mays. Thelma Johnson from Madison pledges $100 in memory of Earl Johnson and Wick Clemens. Name Withheld pledges $25.
Okay, good pledges yes. there. Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you calling and tuning in with us tonight. And just wanted to remind you that you can send your pledges in different ways. So you can send it in by email. You can send it in, go in online on www.wljc.com, which is on the screen right now, scrolling down there. And you can also call it in, you can just mail it in or whatever, and we'll take care of it for you. And we appreciate it very much if you just go ahead and send that in as soon as you pledge it, and that way it helps our bookkeepers at the very end. And we only have three more nights, so if you're thinking about it, if it's in the back of your mind, you're contemplating it, just go ahead and pledge it, and so it won't be so rough at the end either.
Amen.
A lot of people wait, but that's okay. We'll take it Friday and Saturday night, but yeah. It'd help us out a lot if you just go ahead and call that in, so we sure appreciate it. Okay, we're ready to go back to Heaven's Jubilee, and they're out of East Bernstadt, Kentucky, and 423-912-3552, and you'll be speaking with Tammy, and that's the one that's doing the lead singing over there. That's Tammy, so, and they're doing a wonderful job, and we appreciate them so much coming out and help us out by working together. We've got good phone operators. We've got good singers tonight and MCs, so we're just ready to go. So if y'all just get on those phones and call and help us, we sure would appreciate it. We've got to keep WLJC. I was thinking coming up here, we've got to keep WLJC on the air. Yeah. I mean, you know, it's a big church, if you think about it. I mean, it's reaching a lot of people that regular churches can't reach. I mean, you think about it. You know, so it's just feeding in there. And so Heaven's Jubilee, and they do have CDs. So if you call that number, 423-912-3552, Tammy will help you get a CD. So we'll go back to Heaven's Jubilee.
I thought we was going to be off stage for a few. Yeah. I thought we was going to get some more of that good food back there.
I want to send this out to my husband, Dewey Feltner. I know he's watching tonight, and my other family that's watching, we want to send this out to you, and then all those that is watching it. Be a blessing to you.
Were you there when they drove him
up the hill. Oh, sometimes caused me to tremble. Were you there when they drove him up the hill?
Send that out to Alexis Dawn Madden. She's going to be 14 or 15, I don't know, but she is definitely one of God's children. I mean, she is powerful with the Lord. And her bub, Dakota Madden, their mommy and daddy, and my mother-in-law, Brenda Williams, my wife, Tina, and Shannon and Whitney. And my family, brother, and four sisters.
Did you get Brenda? unto the Lord, unto the Lord, crying holy,
unto the Lord,
unto the Lord,
unto the Lord.
Lord, if I could, I surely would stand on that rock,
bones of stood.
Lord, I ain't no stranger now, no, I ain't no stranger now. I've been introduced to the Father and the Son. Lord, I ain't no stranger now. Crying holy
unto the Lord.
Crying holy unto the Lord. Lord, if I could, I surely would stand on that rock.
Lord, I
stood.
Better hold, stand on tonight. Glory to God. He's a rock in a weary land. Glory to God. And I'm glad I've got somebody I can call upon. When everybody else is gone and let me down, I can call on King Jesus. And he never has failed me. Glory to God. And I feel his good spirit here tonight. Glory to God.
All of our kids, a lot of people asked me to sing a song for them, and I can't remember names, but God knows who you are, and I'm honored and thankful to be here tonight, and I just hope it's a blessing to all of you. I'm alone in this world, not a thing do I own. But I'm saved and I'm happy, and I'm on my way home. I've started this journey, and I'll not complain. I'll have a new home, yes I will, designed by a king. Designed by a king in the beautiful somewhere. My father is rich and he owns everything. Now I'm an heir to the Father and a joint heir with Jesus. Home, yes I will, designed by a king.
30-some days that, gosh, if it wasn't for the Lord, I surely could not make it. You know, I mean, it gets stressful out and about in the world and everything, but, you know, if you can just steal away and pray sometimes, you know, I guess that's the reason gospel play. That's the reason I wrote that song, just want to steal away, because I'm telling you, young, sometimes if we don't get to ourselves and just steal away, you know, I mean, it doesn't matter what we're going through. Sometimes we can be so stressed out and under pressure and everything, but if you'll just steal away and you know, and get down and pray and get busy with the Lord, you can walk away with that peace, and I tell you, he'll sure keep you.
Yes, he will.
You know, I'm going to send this out to, let me get in right cord here, to my friends and stuff at Laurel County Detention Center. And I hope they're watching. And if you are watching, y'all better call in and donate. Sing and they begin to shout. But I tell you what, even when they was in there, the jailers and the guards and everybody ended up getting saved. So, you know, I always tell some people, you know, they get thrown in jail, they're like praying for their loved ones and all this, that, and the other, and then they end up in jail. I'm like, well, you know, don't think that a strange thing, because God is going to throw you a safety net at one time or another, and it may just be jail, you know, because God's going to get you somewhere where he can get your mind clear, get you still enough and long enough to be able for you to listen to him. And he's going to give you a chance to be merciful to you. So don't think it's strange if you get thrown in jail, because sometimes, like I said, that might just be the Lord throwing you a safety net, and it may be for the last time.
And his son, they call him Jesus. He came to heal, love, and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon, an empty grave. I'll see the lights of glory and I.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, that's hallelujah. I know that you're enjoying that singing, and even though we're in a telethon, if the Spirit of the Lord is speaking to your heart tonight and you want to give your heart to Jesus, you can do it right there where you're at. All you have to do is call upon Him.
Amen.
Say, Lord, forgive me of my sins. Come into my heart. Or if you need to call in, and they'll pray with you up there. The phone operators will pray with you. There's been a few already got saved during the telethon, and that's what we're up here for. Like the sister said earlier, we're not here to entertain anyone. We're just here to lift up the name of Jesus, and so that Spirit can draw you to Him, and you can give your life to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As I look over these pledges, I think about the people. I believe most of the people that call in and pledge, they're doing their very best. I believe a lot of them are doing their very best. And this station has been supported for years by people giving 10 and 20 and 50 and 100. And the Lord has always supplied the need.
Amen.
Of course, there's those of you that's listening, you know, that you could call in much more than that. And I pray that you will tonight, that you'll just obey the Lord. God gives us the very air that we breathe. You know, when He created man, He breathed into him the breath of life, and He can take that breath back. He said He takes away their breath and they die, and that's all that has to happen in order for us to die, is He calls that breath back, and you're gone. But, you know, don't you want to lay up some treasure in heaven? Don't you want to do something for the Lord that's going to count? You know, many people lay up a lot of stuff down here. I was talking to a guy the other day, and he works all the time. It's amazing at how much he's accumulated in his lifetime. But I thought as I left him, I thought, what good's it going to do him? If he's not laying up treasure in heaven, what good's it going to do him? You know, but we really do appreciate these pledges that's being called in here. Charlie Petrie from Laurel pledges 100 and says he's enjoying the singing. Rosie Gooden from Casey pledges 100. Wilma Thorpe from Lee pledges 10 in memory of Jack Thorpe, Geraldine McIntosh, and Brother Roy. Margaret Dickens from Perry pledges 25 in honor of all the people that work at WLJC. Margaret Isaac from Montgomery pledges 100 in memory of her parents and brother J.D. Trimble. Farry Rader from Jackson pledges 50 in memory of loved ones that's gone on. Tim and Kathy Montgomery from Boyle pledges 50. Gladys Hunter from Fayette pledges 25. J.C. Trent from Wolf pledges 100 in memory of Ovi Trent, Ronald Trent, and Junior Trent, and also in honor of Fred Finley and Larry Collins.
Praise the Lord. Name withheld from Montgomery pledges $25 in memory of Pastor Kenneth Gross. Name withheld from Floyd pledges $100 in honor of tonight's singing group. Ray Tillett from Lincoln pledges $100 in memory of wife Margaret. Carolyn Pitts from Montgomery, $50 in memory of friend Jamie. Willard and Easter Campbell from Breathitt, $200 in honor of Dottie Combs. Billy Joe and Linda Sumter from Harrison, $20 in honor of Sister Margaret and all the workers. Ernest and Stella Vaughn from Versailles, $50 in honor of all the family members, children and grandchildren. Heaven's Jubilee is their favorite. Sue Blackman from Powell, $25 in memory of mother and father. Body of Christ Ministries from Estill pledges $100. Ruth Raines from Wayne pledges $20. Elizabeth from Round, $30. Geneva Cox from Morgan pledges $100 in honor of children Danny, Rhonda, Robbie, and her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Terry Brooks from Powell, $20 in honor of Jesus. Ruth Ulam from Pulaski, $25. Geraldine White from Scott, $50 in honor of the workers at WLJC. Jean and Catherine Adkins from Scott, $100. Praise the Lord.
Good pledges there.
Praise the Lord.
Ralph and Lucille Phelps from Pulaski, $100 in honor of 4 children, 9 grandchildren, 11 great-great-grandchildren, especially her great-granddaughter Sydney Rose Burlock. She turned 2 years old today, and happy birthday to Sydney. Lucille loves Sister Margaret. Lucille wants prayer for her sister Louise, Hasty and her husband and granddaughter, Penny Hart and their daughter Linda and husband Jim, and son Philip and his wife Marcia. So that's from Ralph and Lucille Phelps from Pulaski County, $100. Okay, we're ready to go back to Heaven Jubilee, and they're from East Bernstadt, Kentucky, and their number is 423-912-3552, and he'll be speaking with Tammy. So we'll go back to Heaven's Jubilee.
I'll send this out to Liz and Roger Gibson, good preacher man, and Hoss Whitaker and my grandma Reba Johnson.
What's that I hear?
It comes from above.
It's a voice of angels.
Sharing God's love.
Just reach out and touch him. He's reaching for you. Yes, Jesus is waiting. And he'll see you through. Have you ever been praying and you feel you're all alone? You cry out, oh Lord, where did I go wrong? Then a voice from heaven says, child, just hold on. It'll soon be over, child, you're not alone. What's that I hear?
It comes from above.
It's a voice of angels. Sharing God's love. Just reach out and touch him. He's reaching for you. Yes, Jesus is waiting, and he'll see you through. Have you ever been burdened with troubles and trials, and you don't feel you could go another mile? Then a voice from heaven says, child, just hold on. It'll soon be over, child, you're not alone. What's that I hear? It comes from above. It's a voice of angels. Sharing God's love. Just reach out and touch him. He's reaching for you. Yes, Jesus is waiting, and he'll see you through. Yes, Jesus is waiting. He's waiting on you.
Bob and Kathy Shepherd, Carolyn Cheek, Irene Alsop, and you know, like I said, it's real important that this station stay on the air. You know, there's a lot of souls that depends on this station. Like I said earlier, I think sometimes that there's more sinner people that watches it. They won't go to church, but you know they'll watch this. So y'all call in and make your donations because the. You know, the way I look at it, you bless somebody that's trying to do something for the Lord, and you're going to get blessed in return.
Oh, Lord, I'm striving, trying
through this old weary land. And as I go from day to day, I can hear my Savior say, trust me, child,
oh, trust me, child,
and I'll hold your hand.
I want to send this out to the church where I go to, River of Life, where Charlie Helton is the pastor. And, we have so many requests and stuff we forget, but I certainly want to send this out to them tonight and send this out to families that's listening. And but like I said, if we don't get your request, then you're not to don't get mad at us. Yeah. Oh, Lord, yeah. And I don't know if Sister Imogene's listening tonight or not, but I want to send this out to her and her people. Glory to God.
And you know, if Ricky Milton, his wife Carol Milton's watching too, I'm sending this out to them. Maybe we'll run into them for too much longer.
The Lord gave me this song back. I guess it's been pretty close to 2 years ago, and I've sung it all over the place. As old saying says, I've sung the far out of it.
To be my friend. Oh, I need somebody I can lean on. Blessed Jesus, let me lean on you. Let me lean on you, Lord. When I'm down and out, let me lean on you. Troubles and doubts, let me not grow weary when everything goes wrong. Blessed Jesus, just let me hold on. When I've done all I can, Lord, I need rest. When I'm tempted, oh, I put to test. And when I'm tempted by the devil, you see, God will show up. God will show up and chase the devil away. Let me lean on. Let me lean on you, Lord, through my troubles and doubts. Let me not grow weary when everything goes wrong. Blessed Jesus, just let me hold on. Blessed Jesus, let me hold on.
You know what heaven means to me?
cannot walk. Or you may be dumb and you cannot talk. But when the Lord gets ready, you've got to move.
I really enjoy that. You know how the Lord inspires us to and prompts us by His Spirit to do something? And when the Lord gets ready, we should move.
That's right. Yeah.
And I believe there's people out there, God's moving on them to just bless this ministry. Mm-hmm. But Ray and Vicki Shoulder from Dangville, Indiana, pledges $100 in memory of Wilma Witt. Ella Williams from Morgan pledges $20 in memory of Kenny Williams. Carol and Gerald Amix from Morgan pledges $20. Nettie and Lonnie Davidson from Knox pledges $10 in memory of Evelyn Smith. Name withheld from Pulaski pledges $25. Name withheld from Bath pledges $50. Oscar Cup from Jellicoe, Tennessee pledges $25. Martin Pribula from Pulaski pledges $25. Ines Whitaker from Letcher pledges $10 in honor of daughter Elaine. Lula Crowdis from Fayette pledges $20. And this is a special woman in my life. Judy Prophet from Estill County pledges $25 in honor of her pastor. And it's an honor to pastor her. And so I just love them. Amen. Harvin Gladys Hensley from Manchester pledges $200 in honor of children and grandchildren and in memory of those going on. Name withheld from Clark pledges $100. Carolyn Creek from Lee pledges $20 in honor of Jack Thorpe, Roy and Geraldine McIntosh. Frank and Mildred Duncan from Whitley pledges $25 in memory of Freeman Saylor and in honor of Jesus.
All right.
Amen.
Those are some good pledges. We're glad to have them, aren't we? We're so thankful that to be a part of the telethon. And don't forget to call in your pledge. And we need to just want to remind you, but people just tuning in, if you can pledge different ways, so you can go online and do it at www.wljc.com, and this has a donation thing there. Just click on it, and he'll walk you through how to every step, how to do it. So simple. And then you can email us, so you can email our address, and then you can call us, or you can just mail it in, or you can just drop it off. We'll take it any way you give it to us, won't we? We do try to make it easy for you, so there's different ways for different people to do things. We know a lot of the older people don't have computers and they can't go online and do all that, so that's the reason we do the phone calls and the mailing. I mean, if you don't even have a phone, you can still call, you know. So we thank God that there are different ways to make pledges and donate. So we're just thankful that you're helping us and that WLJC is going to stay on the air for another 6 months anyway, aren't we, Alan? Brother Bill? So we just thank God for that. But now it's time to go to our promotional video. That's just a tokens of appreciation. We're not giving you gifts for your donation, your pledges. We're just saying we appreciate you and thank you for giving your donations. And it's just above and beyond to show our appreciation to you for pledging. So now we'll go to our promo.
WLJC is brought to you by the tithes and offerings of viewers like you. Because of your prayers and financial support, we continue to expand and reach across Kentucky and around the world with the gospel of Jesus Christ. WLJC would like to invite you to help spread the gospel this Spring Telethon. We appreciate your support. As a token of our appreciation, we are giving everyone that contributes during the WLJC Spring Telethon a special gift. For any amount given, you will receive the WLJC bookmark. This super thin magnifier is a full width 3-power lens and is perfect for reading small print. The die cut tab on the back holds it in place as a great bookmark. For your gift of $100 or more, you will receive a pair of WLJC earbuds with a plastic storage case printed with the WLJC logo. Listen to your favorite musicians in private or on the go with these quality earbuds. For your gift of $500 or more, you will receive the WLJC acrylic paperweight featuring the WLJC logo in blue with a glass-like appearance that's crystal clear and unbreakable. It will be a great addition to any desk. Thank you for your support of the WLJC ministry.
Welcome back for our second half of our Spring Telethon. And we just wanted to remind you, and we just have 3 more nights after tonight. So we have Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, and we'll be finished until the fall. So don't forget to get on those phones and call. And we have a whole new singing group up, and Heaven's Jubilee did a wonderful job, and we thank God that they came all that way to help us out tonight. We appreciate them so much. But now we have the Tarr Ridge Union Church. Brother Allen, do you know this group?
Yeah, just a little bit.
Just a little bit? Okay.
I don't know if they'll claim me or not.
They're out of Frenchburg, Kentucky, and their number is 606-768-3859. And the contact person would be Alan. So, and Alan's their pastor, so I know he's proud of him. And I think there's one over he's extra proud of, isn't he? Yeah. In the middle there, in that pink, probably. Right. Yeah, little short lady. We won't say that, Alan. She may whip us. Okay. Well, we won't go there. Okay. So we'll go over to the Tarr Ridge Union Church. God bless y'all.
Praise the Lord. We're just here to lift up the name of Jesus. We thank him tonight. Real privilege to be here, and we thank him for it.
I'm going home with Jesus in the twinkling of an eye. I've made my reservation for a mansion in the sky. I may not know the moment, and I may not know the day, but I know that I'll be leaving when he calls his church away.
Well, the captain of the vessel is calling, get on board. Destination's heaven, safe on that crystal shore. We'll be with our splendid Savior and our loved ones gone before. We'll spend all eternity. Thank God I'm going home. Oh, I'm going home with Jesus in the twinkling of an eye. I've made my reservation for a mansion in the sky. May not know the day, but I know that I'll be leaving when he
Want to be ready to go.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you or evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free from your passion and pride? There's power in the blood. Jesus, your King, there's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you live daily His praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the
blood. The blood. The blood. Hallelujah. Satan hates the blood. And we love the blood because it paid for our sins. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord tonight. Sorry, we got a little mixed up here.
It is you, Lord, who came to save the heart and soul of every man. And it was you, Lord, who knows
Well, aren't they doing a good job? I know that you're enjoying all this good singing tonight, and we thank you for watching, and we thank all of you that's called in tonight. We're up to 112,000. So we're doing really good. We've got three more nights after tonight, but we need you to call in when you think about it, and you can take a break from listening to this good music. I know that you will call in and help us with this because we need all your help. We need to keep the station on the air. This is just for WLJC. It's not for anything else that you see on the station. It's for WLJC only. And we want to be sure that you send it in to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, as in yes, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Now, we know that you're enjoying it. We'll let you go back and listen to them. Keep calling us.
Breathe on me, Lord God. Fill me with power, that I might lead others before the judgment hour. Manifest your kingdom here in this time. Breathe on me, Lord God, holy, sublime. I feel your presence wherever I go. In each circumstance, you're with me, I know. Whatever comes my way, Lord, I can't despair. The fact that you are God, you're all I share. Breathe on me, Lord God. Fill me with power, that I might lead others before the judgment hour. Manifest your kingdom here in this time. Breathe on me, Lord God, holy, sublime. On us, Lord God, fill us with power,
that we may lead others before the judgment hour. Manifest your kingdom here in this time. Unite us as one God, holy, sublime. Fill us with you, Lord, wherever we go. In each circumstance, you're with us, we know. Whatever comes our way, Lord, we can't despair. The fact that you are God and you're all we share. Breathe on us, Lord God. Breathe on us, Lord God. Breathe on us, Lord. So many troubles, so much despair. Yet through them all, I feel you're there. I'm not alone, and I'll make through. You overcame all, thus I do too. So I seek your face. I cry for your will. I sing unto you, for you are most real. Fill me with word and manifest you. For all us lies, you are most true. I cannot rest till my life is done. Must intercede for another one. I rebuke evil by spirits too. Proclaim my family will follow you. So I seek your face. I cry for your I sing it to you, for you are most real. Fill me with word and manifest you. For all the lies, you are most true. Through all my troubles and my despair, Lord, through them all, I know you're there. I'm not alone, and I'll make it through. You overcame all, thus I do too. So I seek your face. I cry for your will. I sing it to you, for you are most real. Fill me with word that manifests you. For all the lies, you are most true. I give myself, please manifest through.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Sue Blakeman, Charles Riley from Powell, $25 in memory of father and mother, Faye and Junior Blakeman. And Alan and Mary Moore from Mason pledges 20. Name withheld from Harlan pledges 25. Larry Phyllis from Lincoln pledges 20. Jenny Storm from Laurel pledges 100. Estelle Gear from Fayette pledges 10. Stella Pelfrey from Breathitt pledges 50. Francis Rowland from Scott pledges 100 in memory of mother and father and husband. Name withheld from Madison pledges 100. Betty Scher from Scott pledges 20 in memory of Anna Green. Louise Sims from Mercer pledges 100 in memory of Pastor Tony Smith and wife Christy. Stella Collett from Fayette pledges 10 in memory of mom and dad. Name withheld from Laurel pledges 75. Elma Lewis from Montgomery pledges 15 in honor of Heaven Jubilee. Glenn and Junior Vance from Garrett pledges 100. Ruth and Howard Reffitt from Harrison pledges 100 in memory of Gerald. Doris Lewis from Floyd pledges 50 in memory of husband Thomas Lewis Jr. Jewel Helton, Wayne and Russ from Knox pledges 50 in honor of Reverend Damon Helton. Amen.
All right, we appreciate all these pledges that's been called in. We appreciate each one of you. You know, Sister Edith, there's only one church in the Bible. I mean, really, you only read about one church. And I thought about today, you know, when the Lord started the church, it was the church at Ephesus, the church at Corinth, and they just went by the area that they was at, wasn't it? But it was the church, you know. And and really there is still just one church. I know there's many denominations, but if you're born again, you're part of that one church. No matter what part of the world you're in, you're still part of that one church if you've been born again and asked Jesus to come into your heart. You know, so we're all working together to lift up the name of Jesus, because there's no other name. There's no other name under heaven whereby men can be saved. So this station is here to lift up that name. And, you know, tonight, if you love the Lord, I think about that saying. It says only one life and it'll soon be passed, and only what we do for Christ is going to last. Amen. And that's so true. That's the truth. I mean, you know, I can get out here and I can work and work and work to accumulate things. But it's not going to do me any good if I don't give to the Lord, you know. You know, just ask God tonight. Say, Lord, what would you have me to do? Because the time is short, and there's many souls that needs to be saved. You know, there's so many, as the sister said a while ago, there's so many people listen to this station that's not saved yet. And so it needs to stay on the air, and the gospel and the word needs to keep going out. You know, even our own government is beginning to fight against the freedom to preach the word. But as long as we have this freedom, we need to reach out to as many people as we possibly can.
Yes, sir.
Because there's so many lost souls. You know, it seems like to me, Brother Bill, that sometimes people get saved and they just sit down.
Yeah.
And they say, well, I'm saved, you know, I'm okay. And it's like they're not really that concerned about other people. But I believe we should really have a burden to see other people saved and other people healed and delivered from sin. Yeah.
Right.
But I appreciate the singers that come with us tonight. And, you know, I started pastoring this church about 5 years ago, and there was a lot of good singers there when I started pastoring, and since then there's been others come. And tonight we have a brother. He comes and sings at our church quite often, but if Scott Barn wasn't such a good preacher, I could probably get him to come more, but because, no, I'm just joking, Brother Bob. Brother Bob Haddix has come to help us tonight, and we really appreciate him. He does come up and sing at the church a lot, and we really appreciate him. And so we're going to go over and let you listen to him. But call in your pledges, and keep calling in honor of your pastor and the people that has been a blessing to you. Keep calling in honor of them, but keep calling in your pledges as you listen to the singing tonight.
Thank you, Brother Allen, for allowing me and asking me to come up, and what an honor it is to come here and sing tonight. As I sing these songs, just listen to the words and think on Jesus Christ and let him come into your heart. And if you feel the need to give and want to give and help this cause out, that would be a good thing. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to feel, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear in the hour I first believed. And my chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, his mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. The Lord has promised good to me, and his word my hope secure. He will my shield and portion be as long as life endures. And my chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, his mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, his mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. The earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine. But God who called me here below will be forever. Will be forever mine. And you are forever mine. Thank you. I love this next song.
There's a peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I will rise when he calls my name. No more sorrow, no more pain. I will ride on eagle's wings before my God, fall on my knee and ride. I will ride. There's a day that's drawing near, when this darkness fades to light, and them shadows disappear, and my faith will be my eyes. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I will rise when he calls my name. No more sorrow, no more pain. I will rise for my God, fall on my knee and ride. I will ride. And I hear the voice of many angels sing, fall on my knee and ride. I will ride. I will ride.
Thank you. How many out there needs a Savior tonight? You know, God looked down and knew we'd need a Savior.
Mm-hmm.
How many names can I use to explain the love of my Jesus, the life that he gave? And so many times will I praise you today. I lift up my life, 'cause you're always the same. In my offering to you I bring, your name is Jesus, your name is Jesus, you're the wonderful counselor, my friend. You're what I hold on to. I know that you brought me through all the days of loss to the cross. You knew that I need a Savior. And how many songs can I sing to proclaim of your wondrous love? Oh, and beauty so great. What would I say if you brought down the rain? Oh, and every day I'd walk through the pain, my heart would still say, your name is Jesus, your name is Jesus, you're the wonderful counselor, my friend. You're what I hold on to. I know that you brought me through all the days of loss to the cross. You knew that I'd need a Savior. Well, I need a Savior. You're what I hold on to. I know that you brought me through all the days of loss to the cross. You that I need a Savior, that I need a Savior. Well, I need you, Savior. You're the one who walked on water, and you calmed the raging sea. You command the highest mountain to fall upon their knee. You're the one who welcomed sinners, and you opened blinded eyes. You restored the brokenhearted, and you brought the dead to life. Forgetting all our sin, you remember all of your promises. You are amazing, more than amazing. Forever our God, you're more than enough. You are amazing. With authority you've spoken, and you set the captives free. You're the King who came to serve, and you're the God who washed our feet. You're the one who took our burdens, then you bled upon the cross. And in your kindness and your mercies, you became the way for us. Forgetting all our sin, you remembered all of your promises. You are amazing, more than amazing. Forever our God, more than enough. You are amazing, more than amazing. Forever our God, more than enough. Oh, how
someone's things redeemed. Seems like all I could see was a struggle. I'm haunted by ghosts that live in my past. Bound up in
shackles of all of my failure. I'm wondering how long is this gonna last? Then you look at this prisoner and say to me, son, stop fighting a fight. It's already been won. I am redeemed, and you set me free. So I'll shake off these heavy chains, wipe away every stain. I'm not who I used to be. I am redeemed. And all my life I have been called unworthy. I'm named by the voice of my shame and regret. But when I hear you whisper, child, lift up your head. I remember, oh God, you're not done with me yet. I am redeemed, and he set me free. So I'll shake off these heavy chains, wipe away every stain. I'm not who I used to be, because I don't have to be the old man inside of me. His day is long dead and gone, because I've got a new name and a new life, and I'm not the same, and the hope that will carry me. And he set me free. So I'll shake off these heavy chains, wipe away every stain. I'm not who I used to be. I am redeemed, and he set me free. So I'll shake off these heavy chains, wipe away every stain. I'm not who I used to be. Oh no, I'm not who I used to be. Jesus, I'm not who I used to be. I am redeemed. Thank God, redeemed.
Amen. I'm glad to be redeemed tonight. Amen. Amen. As the Bible says, let the redeemed say so.
Hallelujah.
And so I'm just glad to be here tonight. Amen. And for the souls that's just being impacted. You know, years ago I was watching a Christian broadcast station like this, and you know, it impacted me. And I encourage people out there tonight, if you got lost loved ones, give tonight in honor of those that's lost. That's one day, maybe it might be your son or daughter that's going to turn in to WLJC like I did, and just let the Lord deal with their hearts through this TV station. Lucy Jones from Montgomery, 100 in memory of mother-in-law. Louise Robinson from Woodford, 25 in memory of Charles Robinson and Vicki Ford. Lord England from Laurel, $25 in memory of the Lord. Sarah Horn from Pike, $50. Name withheld from Perry, $100. Barry and Kathy Kirk from Franklin, $100. Betty Evans and family from Menifee, 100 in memory of O.P. Evans, Audrey and Menifee, $40 in honor of Pastor Alan Ratliff. Well, they're just blessing tonight for Brother Alan. Amen.
This is your night, Alan.
Hallelujah. Rosa Eversole from Lee, 25. Lorene Burton from Wolf, 25, in memory of Ishmael Burton. Bernice Elam, $25 from Brenda Evans. Name withheld from Wayne, 100. Willa Dean Lawson from Wolf, $100, in memory of Jean Lawson. I'm a Jean Steely from Whitley, $20. Sue from Madison, 25.
All right, good job.
Amen.
Alan, you can't help if you're just a good pastor, can you?
No, hallelujah.
It just comes natural. I wish Freddie was here. He'd have something to say about that, wouldn't he? But that Freddie, we love him, though. Like Cecil, we love him, don't we? Okay, we're ready to go back to our second group of singers. And don't forget to call and pledge now to help us out here. We need to get to that 200,000 by Saturday night for sure. So y'all get on the phones and help us if you can. And they're from Frenchburg, Kentucky, and their contact number is 606-768-3859. And contact person be Brother Alan you'll be speaking to. So we'll go back to the Tarr Ridge Union Church.
We mainly just sing at church.
Come on over here.
Come on over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. The feast of the Lord is going on.
Come on over here.
Come on over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. And the feast of the Lord is going on.
There's victory here.
There's victory here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. The Lord is going on.
There's victory here.
There's victory here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. And the feast of the Lord is going on.
Come on over here.
Come on over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. And the feast of the Lord is going on.
Come on over here.
Come on over here.
Where the table is spread
and the feast of the Lord is going on.
There's healing here.
There's healing here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread and the feast of the Lord is going on.
There's healing here.
There's healing here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread and the feast of the Lord is going on. Come on over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. And the feast of the Lord is going on.
Come on over here.
Come on over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. And the feast of the Lord is going on.
There's joy over here.
There's joy over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. The Lord is going on.
There's joy over here.
There's joy over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. And the feast of the Lord is going on.
Come on over here.
Come on over here.
Where the table is spread.
Where the table is spread. And the feast of the Lord is going on.
Come on over here.
Come on.
Sister Sharon, that's for you. Need to pray for Sister Sharon. She just lost her husband, and we just want to know we're thinking about her. Praise the Lord.
The shepherd leads me out to green pastures where the clean
not alone. He is my shield, and when I'm weary, alone and forsaken, He lifts me up. He is so real, though I may stray in the fields that are barren, where danger waits me, I may go. The Master will search until He finds me. He'll guide me back into the fold. I'm one of His sheep. He'll love and protect me when I call. He's there close by. The day draws near for that final journey to that green pasture in the sky.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
This is Brother Neff Jones.
This song is what a lot of people is looking for. They're looking for something.
Amen.
They're needing an answer, and they're finding it hard.
Amen.
But if they'll go to the Bible,
yeah.
The Bible's got the answer for every problem we have.
Yes,
it don't matter what that problem might be. He has got a way, and if we will just accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior,
yes.
He's going to help us through any problem that we do come across.
Yes, amen.
Looking for answer, you need a way out. You've been trapped in a trial full of sorrow and doubt. You saw a trickle of sunlight, but you found no escape. Just hold on to His promises. He said He'd make a way. He'll make a way in the middle of nowhere, when it seems that no one really cares. He's there by your side. He'll make a way. When you feel Satan closing in, don't give up, don't give in. He'll make a way right on time. Standing at the Red Sea, no place to go. Pharaoh's army is closing in. All they'll soon overthrow. But right out of nowhere came a mighty strong hand, and He rolled back the water. He made a way out again, and He'll make a way in the middle of nowhere, when it seems that no one really cares. He is there by your side, and He'll make a way. When you feel Satan closing in, don't give up, don't give in. He'll make a way right on time. Standing at the Red Sea, no place to go. Pharaoh's army is closing in. All they'll soon overthrow. But right out of nowhere mighty strong hand, and he rolled back the water. He made a way out again, and he'll make a way in the middle of nowhere when it seems that no one really cares. He is there by your side, and he'll make a way when you feel Satan closing in. Don't give up, don't give in. He'll make a way right on time.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Glory. Let's do come and die.
I don't know where it's at. I'm sorry, I'm throwing a.
Okay.
That's in C.
C.
Jesus has a table spread where the saints of God are fed. He invites his chosen people, come and dine. With his manna he doth feed and supplies our every need. Oh, 'tis sweet to sup with Jesus all the time. Come and dine, the Master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. The disciples came to land, thus obeying Christ's command, for the Master called to them, come and dine. There they found their heart's desire, bread and fish upon the fire. Thus he satisfies the hungry every time. Come and dine, the Master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. Soon the Lamb will take his bride to be ever at his side. All the host of heaven will assemble be. Oh, 'twill be a glorious sight, all the saints and spotless wife, and with Jesus they will feast eternally. Come and dine, the Master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turn the water into wine. To a hungry calleth now, come and dine.
Praise the Lord. Hey. I think that's what it says. I'm thankful tonight. Praise the Lord.
Well, Jesus said it is expedient for me to go away, but I'll send you another comforter to guide you from day to day. So they tarry at Jerusalem. Sometimes it
gentle and sometimes like a mighty rushing wave. That same Spirit that raised Jesus up from death and the grave, well, it will raise this body up and take me home someday. Well, they laid him in an empty tomb and they rolled an old stone at the door. They put soldiers there to guard him. You know, they thought they'd done away with my Lord. But on that third day, the stone was rolled away and he came forth from the grave. That same Spirit that raised Jesus up will take me home someday. Oh, I can feel his Holy Spirit dwelling deep within. Well, sometimes it feels so gentle and sometimes like a mighty rushing wind. That same Spirit that raised Jesus up from death and the grave, well, it will raise this body up and take me home someday.
Glory to God.
Praise the Lord.
Woo.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Yeah. Little David. Yes.
We had a list, but we ain't going back. We just.
Well, the battle's not mine, said little David. Lord, it's thine, I'm in your favor. I'm giving it all to you. I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see that you're really all that I need. 'Cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you. Lord, it's thine. Now, little David, oh, so small. Goliath, oh, so tall. The odds were just too high for little David. So he shook off all of his robe. For with the power of God, he was clothed. Said the battle's not mine, I give it to you. Lord, it's thine. No, the battle's not mine, said little David. Lord, it's thine, I'm in your favor. I'm giving it all to you. I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see that you're really all that I need. 'Cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you. Lord, it's thine. Now, little David, unafraid, before Goliath he stood that day. It seemed to be the end of little David. But like the lion and the bear he slew, he said, Goliath, you're coming down too. 'Cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you. Lord, it's thine. No, the battle's not mine, said little David. Lord, it's thine, I'm in your favor. I'm giving it all to you. I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you
that you're really all that I need, cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's thine.
Now little David stood so tall, Goliath was so small, sweet victory had rained on little David. Cause he gave the battle to the one that has the record for getting things done. Said the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's thine. No, the battle's not mine, said little David, Lord, it's thine. I'm in your favor, I'm giving it all to you. I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see that you're really all that I need, cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's thine.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm sorry. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Once like a bird in prison I dwelt, no freedom from my sorrow I felt. But Jesus came and listened to me, and glory to God, he set me free. Yes, he set me free, yeah. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus to see. For glory to God, he set me free. Now I am climbing higher each day. Darkness of night has drifted away. My feet are planted on higher ground, and glory to God, I'm homeward bound. He set me free, yes, he set me free, and he broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, Jesus to see. For glory to God, he set me free. Goodbye to sin and things that confound. Not of this world shall turn me around. Daily I'm working and I'm praying too, and glory to God, I'm going. Broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus to see. For glory to God, he set me free.
So much, Tarr Ridge Church, out of Frenchburg, Kentucky. The number once again is 606-768-3859. Okay, thank you all so much. You're doing a wonderful job. Rob, if you'll come back over with us, honey. Donald Moreland from Mount Vernon is $200 in memory of wife who has gone on. Grady and Joyce Plies from Wayne County, $20. Charles Ross and children from Johnson County, $100 in memory of Dorothy Ross. Name withheld from Pulaski, $50. Dolly Woods from Harrodsburg, $50. Loves Margaret and the Workers. Name withheld from Bath, $25 in honor of Robbie Haddix. Janet from Montgomery, $10. Kenneth and Carl Pitts from Menifee, $100 in memory of their son, Kenneth Dean Pitts. Yvonne and Jennings Hanger from McGoffin, $20. Denzel Back from Menifee, $50 in honor of Alan Ratliff. Kathy from Montgomery, $20 in honor of grandchildren. Charles Thomas From Montgomery, $65 in honor of Bobby. Ruby Centers from Menifee, $40 in honor of Alan and Robin Ratliff. So those are some good pledges still coming in. So now we're getting to a serious time of our night. We always take time to pray for the prayer requests that you call in.
Amen.
And we appreciate you calling them in, because that's what we're here for, is to pray for needs and stuff, you know. So we're going to go now to Brother Bill and Alan, and they're going to take care of the prayer requests and pray over them everything. So.
Amen. We got one, Rosetta Branham, prayer for grandchildren to come back to church and to the Lord. Phyllis Owens and family from Clay County, she's bedfast and in pain. Prayer for Margaret Dickens' family in Perry County. And Pastor Johnny Mullins, called in by a friend from Letcher County, Pine Pentecostal Church. He's a carpenter who got a nail stuck in his eye, and he's really needing prayer right now. He has to go to Lexington tomorrow for more tests. Most of these, Sister Edith is praying for lost loved ones, and so we're going to trust God that God is going to bring them in.
Amen.
Amen.
But we have read, even though he doesn't mention all those on there, we have read through them and looked at them and say, well, anyway, it doesn't matter. God's the one needs to know. But we do look at them and, and view through them. So we just don't want you to think we're just dismissing you because you don't hear your name or something, because we have read through them.
Amen.
Yeah, so many, Sister Edith, that we wouldn't have time to read them all. And, and that just shows how needful this station is, because really the phone operators up there is one of the most important jobs here. And Sister Dottie and all the people that help her do a great job. And, you know, they usually they'll pray when they call in, and then they'll write everything down and send it down here, and we'll anoint it and pray for them again. But people here really do care that you get your healing or whatever you need, whatever the need is that you call in. They really do love you and care about you, and of course, all of us do. We're one guy asked me today if the people got paid to come up here and sing and do this. I said, no, they don't get paid. We do it because we love the Lord and we love people and want to see people get help. I mean, you know, Brother Bill, Jesus, he went about doing good and healing all that was oppressed of the devil, didn't he?
Right.
And we're supposed to walk in his steps, you know, and do the work that he started. And so that's what it's about. It's not about getting on TV or being seen or anything. It's about trying to get the Word of God out, because the truth will set you free. The truth will set you free. This man has called in for his wife from Bath County. Says she's having difficulty breathing. They've called in for a daughter that is in bad pain tonight in her arm and side. Gwen Griffin has cancer and needs prayer. Catherine Atkins just found out she has MS and she needs prayer. Wilma Thomas from Lee County has been sick for 4 days and can hardly talk and needs prayer. Jennifer Stacy has been diagnosed with stage 4 cancer, so she needs prayer tonight. The Prophet family needs to be remembered in prayer tonight. Lula Crowder, or I hope I pronounced that right, needs prayer. Charles Riley and Lois Jean Collette, I believe it is. They're both in need of prayer tonight. Just so many, you know, there's just so many here that needs prayer. So many cases of cancer. And, you know, the Bible says he healed all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. And it says he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. But if you go to the Bible and you look about, you look up the scriptures on healing and faith, that's the one thing it takes, Sister Edith, no matter who it is. Someone has to pray the prayer of faith, you know, and that's all that's required. And whether it's you or whether it's us, You know, he said, if any two shall agree on earth as touching anything they should ask, that he would do it. But we have to come into agreement in faith, believing, and just cast it upon him and say, Lord, I'm trusting you with all my heart, soul, mind, and strength. Yes. And he will not fail you. You know, you can, just like the lady testified earlier, you can take it to the Lord and he will move. You know, he will touch you and heal you if you'll trust him with all your heart. But we want to anoint these and pray over them tonight. And those of you that's listening, we want you to agree because, you know, if we come into an agreement, someone can touch heaven. Someone can touch heaven, and we need to come into agreement on these.
You know, Brother Allen, some of these people that need prayer, that they might not even be in this stack right here, and even those that's backslid on God that's watching tonight. Yes. And we're going to pray with you that God's going to just restore you and bring you back in.
Amen.
And God is a restorer today.
Yes,
and those that fell away from the Lord. And I read some of these, and as Sister Edith said, you know, we're not disregarding, you know, or putting some to the side, but there are so many to read tonight.
Yeah.
And but there's a lot of hurting people out there, but there's people that didn't even call in tonight that's watching. And so if you would just pray with us and agree, as 1 John 1:9 says, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins if we confess him and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And you know, all we have to do is just, you know, salvation is so simple.
Yes.
We just have to ask, you know, for forgiveness. A lot of people has ate it with guilt, and the enemy tries to condemn us. And so that's what this station is about. It's not about, you know, the raising the money. I know it is this last week. But it's about reaching the lost and those that's in trouble with God.
Amen.
So, amen. So we're going to come in agreement and pray right now. And hallelujah. Father, we thank you tonight, God. And Lord, we come in agreement right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we just thank you, God, for all those that just gave to this ministry tonight, God. But most of all, this ministry is here to seek and to save that which is lost. And God, those that's watching tonight, Lord, by TV, God, Lord, I ask you to just go forth, Lord, and just deal with their hearts, Lord. You're a restorer tonight, God. And Lord, there's people that's in condemnation and guilt. And Lord, I'm asking you, God, just wrap your arms of love around them, God, and show them your love. Lord, it's the goodness of God that bringeth forth repentance. And God, those that's sick and afflicted tonight, Lord, move upon these requests tonight, Lord. God, the backslidden children and grandchildren that's in this request, God. Lord, we ask you to move upon them. And this man that got a nail stuck in his eye, God, Lord, we speak healing and restoration upon him right now. Those that's afflicted by cancer, Lord, you sent your word and healed them and delivered them of the destructions. God, we come in agreement right now, Lord. If two touches anything and agrees, it shall be done. And God, you said according to your word that you sent your word and healed, and we speak that word upon them, God. Well, Lord, he that cometh to him must believe that he is. And Lord, we're believing that you are the healer. You are Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. And Lord, we thank you for being our good shepherd, Lord, and our healer, God, our Jehovah Rapha, our provider and our healer, God. And we give you praise in Jesus' name. Lord, we just speak blessing on Sister Margaret in this ministry tonight, God. Lord, we know that you're going to bring and you're going to provide each and every dime that this station needs. And Lord, we just speak peace upon each and every family that's watching tonight, God. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.
Okay. Alan, we'll start with you. We got a few minutes to say something here at the end. So.
Well, Sister Edith, it's just, you know, if people come here and they see what the station's about, you know, it's just so important because, you know, we don't get a lot of channels at our home. I think we got the lowest package you can buy, but we do get WLJC. And, but there's just nothing on TV, you know. If you go through the channels and there's so little on there that will edify a person or help them spiritually. But this station, you know, if you watch it night after night, you don't have to worry about your children. They can watch anything that's on here. And it edifies people. It lifts them up and builds them up. And, You know, I know we're not all perfect and we're not professionals, but we're just working for the Lord, and we're asking, you know, each one of you, and many of you has already done your part. I mean, many of you has already called in and pledged and done your part, but we're just asking you to get behind the station and with your prayers, especially with your prayers and your financial support, and God will take care of it.
Yeah, you know, Sister Edith, God is trying to signal His return.
Yes.
Yeah. And you know, this blood moon that's coming up, I believe tomorrow night, there's going to be four, two last year, two this year, and they have always fallen on Jewish feasts. And that's not by coincidence. I don't believe in coincidence. God is trying to shake this world and wake people up. And if you're going to do something for the Lord, right now is the time to do it.
Yes.
I was bad years ago, bad for procrastinating.
Yeah.
And one time I was in a store and I seen this book. It said procrastinating. And I thought to myself, I'll do that tomorrow. I'll buy that book tomorrow. But, you know, we put things off.
Yeah,
but, you know,
right.
We're going to put things off even with salvation.
Right.
And it's going to be too late.
That's right.
And so what we're going to do right now, let's do that. If you're going to give, as they've been talking about all week, you know, give right now.
Right.
Amen. Don't wait till the last minute.
That's right.
I was just thinking earlier that we'll never know the souls that are reached, you know, from this place. And if we could just see, you know, I think it would be a sea of souls. And I can't stress how much, how important it is that you support this place and the reward in heaven that will be yours. I believe it will be great. And to stand behind this place with your prayers and your finances and every, you know, just Sister Margaret needs lifting up, and just like all the rest of us, you know, we all need lifting up. Before the Lord. Yes, we need strength and we need courage to go on and run those last miles of our journey. And just lift her up.
Good.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Robin. We appreciate Robin and Alan and Brother Bill coming to help us tonight. And somebody will be back tomorrow night, and we'll all be back Friday and Saturday night for sure. So, but we're thankful to our camera people that take care of us so good and lead and guide us. We don't know what we'd do without them.
And the lady that does the cooking.
Yeah,
the
lady. Yep, wonderful job. Phone operators, we can't do it without them.
No.
They tell us all the time, put your mics on. We'd be up here just a mess, but we thank God that God's still God. Just want to remind you now, when you send your pledge in, please send them to Beattyville, Kentucky, not Santa Ana, California.
Amen.
Send them to Beattyville, because we want them to stay locally. And if you send a post office box, why Beattyville, Kentucky, that's where they'll come to, is Beattyville.
Amen.
They'll help WLJC and help get these souls saved. And we're going all over the world, but we need to think of our local people. And,
yes.
You know, and you all was talking about that we're living in the last days. Well, somebody said we're living in Sodom and Gomorrah days. I believe we're living in Noah days.
Mm-hmm.
The world's going to be destroyed.
Yeah.
I mean, not just one place, not one place, but that's just the way I feel about it. But we want to say good night from WLJC in the mountains of good old Lee County. And we'd like to say we love you. And my friend, if we never meet again, my prayer is that we'll meet in the next world to come. God bless you and good night.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.